Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. We're ready to go on Operation Dawnclaw, another one of these guerrilla operations. And are you guys ready? Because I am. Here we go. So the team we're going with is a bit mixed. There's a few veterans in there and a few, lower level guys. Namely, Geralt and Yessie are the ones with less experience. But here we go.
Keeping an eye on an intermittent signal moving through this area, and we think it's tied to an unprotected terminal on board one of the Advent trains. We can't pass up a chance to retrieve their data on the latest alien project, so we're moving on the train. Eliminate all hostile forces with extreme prejudice. If we can seize control of that data, we might have a shot at stopping their progress.
So that was a very, very large explanation to just go and hack some station. We get ourselves a bit of information about a current alien facility, because it's about processing facility schematics, apparently. So here we go. So dropping in Bangalore, in Indonesia. I don't know much about Indonesia, actually, so if anybody in the comments likes to enlighten me, please do.
Move to secure the area. Expect hostile resistance.
There we go. It's been a while since we started out concealed, especially since we haven't been bringing Christophe with us. And apparently we've seen something already. There we go. The turret. That is, I would say an annoying start, but yeah, I'm just going to work around it and I'll see you guys in a minute.
Hostile forces.
Yeah, and Yang spots a Trooper Lancer and an Archon. Shouldn't be that big of a problem either. There's a pole over here, so if I can use Benito to start hacking, I might actually do that as well.
I'm on the move.
There we go, everybody moving up. Let's skip all this.
Closing on target position now.
And then let's check out what the pole can tell us. Here we go, let's try and hack that. And let's see what the bonuses might be. Hypnography. Reduce enemy will by 50% or recovery lead on an alien facility. Well, neither are very good, although the enemy will reduction might help us out in getting a successful mind control. Which I might do in a minute. But yeah, I'm gonna just try and move closer and then we'll see what happens. So yeah, I'm gonna try and hack the turret. Might be a good start, because I can do that without breaking concealment, if I'm not mistaken. There we go. 100% chance to temporarily disable the unit, or 63 to take control. I'm gonna try that, and hopefully we get another ally out of this. Oh shit, that was... yeah, miscalculation on my part. Not that big of a problem, because I can actually deal with that. And of course we're revealed right now. But not that big of a problem. Not that big of a problem at all. So the Archon is going to be pissed. And apparently the Lance is going on the roof. And then down again. That looked very inefficient. And there's the turret. Encroaching on our domain. Oh, look at those abilities on Jazz. I freaking love him already for it. So Reaper. I could do that, but I can't kill any of the guys over here, any of the enemies over here, so I might actually wait with his attacks until I've weakened everything else a bit further. I could take a hit at the super heavy turret. I have a 100% sniper shot, which is pretty good. Although I'd like to get a better one. I do need to be careful that I don't waste any shots here. Stasis mind control. That would be amazing. 63% on the Archon. The Archon has melee attacks, and if I could dominate him, that would be amazing. I have a few backup plans, so we might as well try this. Oh, and her body is missing for some reason. And we got him first try, 63%. Thank you. So that's an Archon in our squad for the next turn, and of course an enemy taken out immediately. Can't use Benito anymore, but I can use everybody else. Yang. Try and get over here. I think I might even use her EMP bomb on the turret, or just the acid bomb. Just an acid bomb, because the... Ooh, wait, an acid bomb over here. Can I put that a bit higher? Well, I saw it. There we go. I think that hits both of them. Yeah, there we go. And end of it. That hit both of them and lost the armor of the turret as well, so that's good. Next up, we should probably try and take out the Lancer over here. Might as well do that with a shotgun blast. But first, I can actually lightning hands. I could lightning hands the Elite Lancer up there, because that doesn't take an action. Might as well try that. If that hits, I have pretty free reign with the... Okay, never mind. Just set a whole lot of stuff on fire. Now I'm just gonna fire at the turret, because that's gonna guaranteed kill it. And that gets us rid of that. There we go, goodbye, 15 damage. Next up is... Geralt still has a shot as well. Might as well use his... Because the trooper over here has 4 health left. I could guess that he dies from the acid burn. So the only guy I really need to kill right now is the Lancer up there. So if I try and position myself a bit closer, shouldn't trigger anything from over there. And I can only see the elite trooper, of course. 6 damage for the proximity mine. And 5-6 on an incendiary bomb. That does hit the Archon as well, which is annoying. Damn it. So I can't hit the Lancer from over here either. Oh wait, that might be a good position. Yeah, like this. There we go. 5 damage and of course some burning applied. And then I do want to get Jazz on the corner here. Shoot. I'm going to see if I let him shoot once or not. I could actually shoot at either of those. If I can take out the Lancer from here, that would be ideal. There we go, goodbye. That's good. And he dropped some loot. What's this? Oh, that was weird. Come on, die. Die. Oh, 1 health left. 1 health left. Is he gonna try and fire at the Archon? That would be the best option here. No, he's gonna run away. Or not. He's going for higher ground. I think he can only hit the Archon from over there, so... That's fine, he's there for that. Might actually use the Archon to kill the trooper in a minute. No, no. What the hell? Holy shit. Okay, that's the loot just dropped down. Probably can't move through here without... Oh, I can. I could actually get over here without... Huh. That would be nice. Then we have the Archon, but wait a second. Can I actually hit the trooper from over here? I can hit him with... Yeah, her body is just gone for some reason. That is an interesting effect. I can't hit the trooper from over there, so that's too bad. But I could get up here and just shoot at him if I want to. What are his abilities? So he can melee attack and then blazing pinions. bombard the target area with a hail of explosive shells. Don't really need to do that just yet. So I'm just gonna move up here with him. Might actually activate something else as well. There's just civilians over there, and then 65% shot. Why not? I think we just killed him by proxy there. Yeah. We shot out the floor underneath him, and then the trooper just fell down. Jazz, get the loot. He's not gonna go through the fire. Oh, he's not taking it. Well then, yeah, I'm gonna have to sacrifice another move with you. Get the loot this way then. There we go. Superior autoloader and an advanced scope, always handy. Then Yang, how far is the train still? So it's that train over there. I might as well move around to the side over here. Let's go around this slowly, and I'll see you guys in a minute. And there we go. I used a few turns later, I used the Archon as a scout, and he spots an officer and a mech. And maybe something else, who knows? No, it seems to be everything there. I have something nice for them though. I could go with the blazing pinions and just bombard the entire area. But I think that only activates in the next turn. Well, you know, why not? Oh, that just happens like that. I think that doesn't do damage immediately. There we go. So, I can't even see him. Wow, he's so high, I can't even see him. Okay, so I can open the door with Jazz. Jazz is still inside the building. And he is around here somewhere. Yeah, he can't really see anybody. So let's just move a bit closer with Jazz. Over here. Shoot. Hopefully he doesn't trigger anything else, because otherwise we're gonna be fucked. Then Yang, move her a bit closer. Vinny, does he have a shot on the mech? A perfect shot, actually. So why not? 100%, and it takes out most of the mech's health. And they can't shoot at me from over there. So that's good for Vinny. Hack defense decreased. And then what else do we have? Because everybody else is pretty much out of reach at the moment. Which is, of course, a benefit, because that means nobody's gonna be able to kill anybody here. There we go. Yessie over there, can't really do anything with her. The grenade will probably be... Can't reach those guys over there, yeah. Just went a bit too far with the Archon there. Sure thing. Just gonna try and move everybody up a bit closer. Just out of their out of the enemy's reach, because they won't see us over here. So yeah, I'm just gonna pull everybody closer without actually doing anything, because that still leaves two enemies wide in the open. I'm wondering how they react to the blazing pinion. So they move clearly. Oh, and there's three more enemies inside of the train, and he marked the Archon, which is really good. Everybody should focus their fire on the Archon. And then, for some reason, the camera is focusing on those crates instead of... Oh, shit. And he missed. They're repositioning on us. That is interesting. He just blindly missed. And there's the blazing pinions, which actually removed Jazz's cover for some reason. He's not on fire, luckily. This is like a covert operation, so three guys are moving in from behind while everybody else is trying to kill those guys. I think I'm just gonna take a pistol shot. Might actually take it out in one shot. There we go. Goodbye, Mac.
Did you see that one?
And then I'm gonna wait with the rest of his actions, because we might have need for him in a minute. He's now Jazz, or the Archon, actually. Ken, what is your shot from over here? Can I go higher, actually? Because Archons can fly, but I can't go higher. I'm gonna melee this guy. Wondering how much chance you get on the melee attack. And this is gonna probably spot those three guys inside of the train. But as long as the Archon is the one drawing the fire, we should
Commander,
be fine.
We have confirmation of the exposed access point.
75%? Ooh, whack! That was nice. I think that was 10 damage. And then, of course, we're gonna go with a melee strike. 100% on the officer. Don't go through the fire, don't go through the fire. Goodbye. Goodbye, officer. Chink. Okay, seems to be positive. And then we move in slowly from behind with the rest of the troops. I do want to be careful that I don't spot them over here. So apparently can't see the three enemies inside there now. So two codexes and an Andromedon. I'm going to have to be really careful how we handle this. Because I don't want to antagonize too many enemies here. If I move in from the back, what would happen? Because I'm guessing... Yeah, put Benito in there. That should antagonize them really, really good. There we go. Two codexes and an Andromedon. Really mad at us. Of course, because they always are. Oh shit, and they all move to the back. Oh, and that is even worse. That might be a problem. But they are really huddled up right next to each other. So I'm wondering. Yang. You have a lot of your in your arsenal, right? Because you have a blaster bomb, which has a really, really big range. But I'm going to have to make choices, apparently. Because I think... If I rotate the camera here a little bit... If I use the blaster bomb... Okay, so there's... Damn it. I can't hit the sectoid in the back, but that's not really the biggest problem. I'd like to hit both the gatekeeper and the Andromedon at the same time, but that's not gonna happen because they're spread out too much. I could take out the gatekeeper with the... Yeah, I'm just gonna do it like this, because if I do this, like this, I think the Andromedon's cover will disappear as well. So that is really, really good. Taking out probably the sectoid, most likely the codex. The codex is gonna survive. But here we go, blaster bomb as a first thingy. Why did she aim that at the ground? That was, oh snap. So the sectoid is almost dead. And then of course the codex is gonna teleport on top of the roof, why not? What else do we have? I could use an EMP bomb, but that's... Can I get, I can, that is amazing. Can get both codex fragments and the gatekeeper in that EMP bomb. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. And then I'm gonna have to use Geralt as the other shredder in this case. Because yeah, we're gonna have to, we're gonna need that. Stunned for two turns because of the EMP bomb, that is good. Because that means he can't attack in the next few turns. Which means I'm actually pretty free to do whatever I want to do. I could grapple towards the train, that's even better.
Grappling.
Let's go to the train and see what happens over there. What we can do from over there. Can I actually see the... Can't see the Andromedon from here. Which is too bad, although I could go inside here. Put myself around here. This should be... But I don't think it is a window. I'm gonna put me over Vinny over there. See what I can do from there. I could probably get a pistol shot in at the codex over here, but it still won't kill him. But I'm in a really good position to finish off everything else if I manage to break down the Andromedon. Yes, you go over there. Because I'm gonna have to shift everybody to the other flank now. What can I bombard? How far can I bombard? pretty much over here, apparently. So this is also something I'd like to do. Blazing pinions from up there. Death from above. There we go. And then Jazz, you shouldn't go running around in there, so might actually should just put you over there. Can Vinny actually fire? He can. So if I put Jazz over here, then he should be able to fire as well, just over each other's shoulder. And then we should have Geralt. There we go, Geralt. Geralt, my man, still has the Shredstorm cannon. So if I use that from over here, how much damage can I actually do? Could actually take out the sectoid as well. Might take out Yang's cover, but at this point, might as well take the loss. Yeah, do that. Blammo! Really, really good. Sectoid down. Then. Could have killed the sectoid with the thingies as well, but... Geralt doesn't have salvo, which is a bit of a problem. Oh, I should have used the rupture shot first. Although, yeah, rupture shot on the Andromedon. And then Vinito ducks. Oh, shit. That is abysmal. Oh, god damn it. Could put the Andromedon in stasis. Which might actually be not such a bad idea. What else do we have? We have Benito shot, who is in a really bad position at the moment. Who could fire at the Andromedon. Gonna have to be really careful here. That's 8 damage, and the aim of... Oh yeah, I kind of forgot that. He boosts the aim of every shot afterwards. So if I use Yessie's normal shot, he should be down, but... Oh, I want to spread out the damage a bit here. Let's fire at the codex over here. Oh god, did that damage the workstation? It didn't. Okay. Jesus Christ. And he clones over there. Yes, he fire at the Andromedon. Getting him out of the suit. Apparently reduces the... Removes the mark as well, which is interesting. And then Vinny still has the face-off, which is gonna trigger target 4 enemies at the moment. Hopefully don't destroy the workstation, please. Don't know why that takes damage. And then misses the idle gatekeeper. And then critical shot on the Andromedon, but does not kill it.
You know that was good.
Now that is interesting. Which means that the Andromedon is gonna try and punch us inside of the train, probably. Oh, there's a lot of enemies still alive. He's gonna do a bomb, yeah. Didn't think he was gonna do that. Which isn't bad. Weapon unaffected. Why was that? Why is the weapon unaffected? Sectoid is going up the building. And is gonna fire at the... Is he mind controlling the mind controlled... Disoriented, okay. Disorienting the Archon, which is good. He's gonna have to move. Oh no, what are you doing? Oh shit. Oh, don't destroy the workstation. Fuck you.
I'm taking fire!
Okay then. Apparently that didn't destroy the terminal. How can I can hack the workstation, which is really good. I'm gonna do that from over here. So I'm not inside of the bomb anymore. There we go. and unhack the workstation, which isn't there anymore, but good riddance then. System override. And then, oh, this soldier's hacking stat permanently increased by 20%. And we get that 100%. So that is a no-brainer for me. Just going to go for that one. Enemy protocol. There we go. 20 hack increased. Which is really, really powerful, by the way. It's the only way to increase the hack stat of a soldier. That is interesting.
Confirm successful acquisition of the advent files.
Okay, then.
Any remaining hostiles in the area.
I'm wondering, how far can I go with the sword strikes? Can't I attack anybody else? Yeah, I can attack the gatekeeper. I can attack the codex. But I probably won't be able to get from one to the other. I'm just gonna try that. So activate Reaper. And then I would get another action every time I kill somebody. But I'm wondering if I can do that. Can I kill this guy actually? 7 to 9, so that should actually kill it. And the first one won't miss, which is really good. Oh, he's gonna explode. Yeah, kind of forgot about that. That shred his armor. That was stupid. I just melee attacked a gatekeeper. Then I get another slash. On the codex. And 100%. That's the second kill. And I don't think I can get back to the, can I slash? Could slash the Archon, but that's a bit stupid. Could use the blast, the plasma blaster. That's annoying as well. It actually hits. The sectoid is just out of my reach. Which isn't too bad, because I'm just gonna try and reload then. Because everybody else should be able to kill the rest. I do wonder why Vinny's gun is unaffected by the bomb. Because is that an effect of the EMP rounds? That is interesting. So I'm just going to put him over there behind cover. And that should be a good enough position to kill him off. But of course I want to have a bit more experience for the guys that still need experience. So I'm just going to put Yessi over here. See what she can do. She can fire at the Andromedon shell 100%. She has EMP rounds, so that should kill it outright. Goodbye. Oh, and flopping around. Oh wow, that is a noise. That is a noise. Oh, I do apologize for that. That is annoying. Arkel, can you go and hit the God damn it, can't I fire at the 35% shot? Why not? Might as well try. Wow. That was a headshot. Well disoriented. Yeah, celebrate all you want. That was a nice shot. Good man.
All hostiles are down in the area.
Okay then. That took a bit of effort.
Mission accomplished.
Too wounded, but we did do it. With a destroyed workstation for some reason. So Yang dealt most damage, Vinny made most attacks. We have a new record in average damage per attack, apparently. The Archon was under fire most, which is interesting. And Jazz, of course, moved the furthest with his Reaper ability. That's the first time we could actually use that. And it's pretty effective if you need to kill off the final enemies of the match. And they have been damaged a bit, but you couldn't finish them off. It's a really handy ability for that, so thank you. And back at the Avenger, we really need to relax after that one, because that was full of explosions, mind-controlling, and everything else. I do wonder how you level up Yessi, because she has 6 skills by now, but she didn't get any promotions either. It's weird that the game said 2 wounded. Oh yeah, because the Archon was probably counted as a wounded soldier, but Jazz was the only one who got wounded because I kind of exploded a gatekeeper in his face. Sorry for that, Jazz. Superior autoloader, advanced scope, and then everything we killed, of course. Thank you very much.
Excellent work, Commander. Your efforts continue to bolster the resistance movement across the globe.
Thank you, Councilman. And with that done, I'm just gonna head towards the bridge. and get the rest of that intel we were trying to get. If the game would want to move on. Resistance contacts. Okay then. Would that just automatically complete one of the
Avenger
contact missions? Or
new course.
How do I need to interpret that?
Strategic
intel in the back. The surrounding territory was pockmarked and burned with ribbons of unusual discoloration marring the landscape. Using the scanners, we managed to follow the ribbons' trails to a downed alien patrol craft. With no signs of life nearby, our team quickly recovered what they could. 55 intel as a reward, okay. And then we have, where is that contact thingy? Resistance contacts. How does that... Because it's not in an area we haven't explored
Avenger
yet. But let's check
course.
That out. Just because we can. Maybe we get another contact slot for free then. That might actually be it. We get another contact slot for free. Well, 5 days is worth that trouble. Jazz has recovered from his wounds, which is really good. And now we have... There we go.
It's the only option we have at this point.
Agreed. We must inform the commander immediately.
Go right ahead.
Commander? Central, the Shadow Chamber has completed its analysis of the Avatar's DNA. It has identified the genetic sequence necessary to travel through the psionic gate.
Perfect. We can finally shut this Avatar project down for good.
However, the gate requires more than a mere transmission of genetic data.
The sequence has to be part of a live subject. The key only works in lockstep with the signal.
We don't have time to find another one of those things, let alone capture it.
No. That part we can handle. We make our own.
You're serious?
Quite. Though the specimen before us is damaged beyond repair, it has provided us with its complete genetic blueprint. We already possess an unaltered Avatar template from the Forge facility. That combined with the genetic material we recovered at the Black Site should allow us to replicate the procedure here.
And make our very own Avatar.
What's the catch?
Yes, that. Without an Elder consciousness driving it, the new Avatar would remain as lifeless as the one before us. While I can develop its body, I cannot create the mind to drive it.
But I can, in a way. By manipulating the new Avatar, via the psionic network.
You want to operate one of these things by remote control?
Not exactly. And definitely not me.
Interfacing directly with their network would cause severe, if not fatal, trauma to an unprepared central nervous system. As it stands, we only know of one individual who has survived that kind of ordeal.
Yes, we, as the commander.
That was different. The stasis suit.
Created the perfect interface to the network. One tailored to your specific biology, Commander. Of any human candidate, you are the most likely to survive the connection.
Most likely.
There we go.
Is not good enough, Doctor.
It is. We're gonna be the final sacrifice.
And our only option to traverse the alien portal.
We need to come up with a game plan before we charge through the enemy's front door. Which will give you some time to think about this, Commander.
And we also need to make an avatar. Just saying.
This specimen, this being, is something else entirely. Something beyond anything we have ever seen. And yet somehow, our troops once again prevailed.
We have dedicated the entirety of our efforts to discovering the purpose of the Avatar Directive, and now it seems we're finally gaining ground on the aliens. With that said, I was shocked to see that our troops not only encountered what was apparently a fully responsive Avatar specimen, but that it engaged them in combat and was subsequently dispatched with only moderate difficulty. With all that went into its creation, I somehow expected that the Avatar would be a foe unlike any other, something perhaps even beyond our own capabilities to counter. Initially, it appeared as though my assumptions were wrong. Humanoid in form, the physical attributes of the Avatar specimen are, on the surface, wholly unremarkable. It has a musculature system not all that unlike a young adult human, with no obvious genetic adulterations to enhance its physical strength or agility. At this point, I could only surmise that the aliens focused entirely on what lies beneath the Avatar's seemingly ordinary structure. As I continued my analysis of the Avatar specimen, including a rapid genetic sequencing aided by the Shadow Chamber, I discovered my earlier conclusions could not be further from the truth. This avatar, what was left of it, is still not whole in a developmental sense. Although portions of the missing genetic links have since been filled with what is undoubtedly an elder DNA, there are still gaps, incomplete sequences that leave the creature unable to fully sustain its own power. It is now my firm belief that we have yet to encounter a fully developed avatar, and its potential capabilities at full strength leave me deeply concerned. There we go. So now, there's a new research, or is there? I'm wondering what we need to do right now. Can we actually... because this is new ground for me. I never completed the game before. So from now on, we're completely on the new ground. Alien data cache or advent data cache? Maybe just go for the berserker.
This fearsome creature, long referred to as a berserker, is clearly a genetic relation to the other mutant species we have encountered in the field. For reasons yet unknown, this particular variant is unique in that it is altogether consumed by what can only be described as blind rage, a thirst for combat, unlike any other creature we've encountered.
Indeed, the berserker. There we go. Let's head back to the bridge. Okay then.
The commander coming through on a secure channel, sir.
On screen.
Sir, it's coming from the Advent Network Tower.
Excuse me?
He's taking a big risk contacting us like this.
Ah, okay, the councilman.
Hello, Commander. You and your crew are to be commended. Your efforts in rebuilding the Resistance Network and uncovering the truth about the Avatar Project have been admirable. I only wish I had better news to report.
When does he ever?
Advent is not taking the death of an elder lightly, and in turn have greatly accelerated the final stages of their Avatar Project. A plan is now in place for the rapid processing of all non-essential human life to begin immediately.
Okay, didn't expect that.
Very soon, Advent's speaker will announce a breakthrough in gene therapy. A final treatment for the human condition. Billions will flock to gene therapy clinics across the globe. They will never return. I have managed to secure tactical data and access codes to the Advent Network Tower. The speaker's address will be broadcast live to a global audience via this facility. The whole of Advent's network will be listening. It is this hubris that we must use against them. The information I am sending you should allow Dr. Tigan and Chief Engineer Shen to take control of the transmission and disrupt their entire network from within.
Interesting.
Though my hope is that this disruption will confuse the enemy's forces long enough to allow your final assault a chance of success, I ask one more thing of you. Take what you have learned. Let the world know what is happening here. Wake them up. Broadcast the truth before there is no one left to listen. It seems we are both out of time.
Oh, wow.
Farewell, Commander.
Wow.
New objective added.
Launch an infiltration mission on the main Advent Network Tower, attempting a shutdown of the global Advent communication network and disrupting Advent's worldwide tower. That is very, very cool.
Commander, I've updated our current objectives based on the most recent findings.
So that just activated because I went to the bridge for some reason. Let's do that again.
Always been elusive.
Yeah. Thank you, Tigan. Sorry for that.
We have the target site locked in, Commander. This is our chance to strike at Advent's heart. Once we control the network tower, we can finally show the world what the aliens are doing. There's no turning back after this.
Interesting. Why would I... In addition to providing logistical coordination for the entirety of Advent's forces, the Advent Network Tower is also responsible for disseminating their propaganda broadcasts to a global audience. We need to disrupt the tower's signal and seize control. Show the world the truth about Advent. And we actually have the option to use intel... Squad aim increased by 15 and crit chance, what the hell? Increased by 25. Squad gains 1 free use of the run and gun ability. Soldier gains complete immunity from the next 2 attack. Targeting is extremely powerful here, but what the hell? Why do we need that? I'm just gonna cancel for now. But I'm assuming we really need to do that. So that's gonna be in the next episode. We're gonna assault the Advent Network Tower, but before that, I'm gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. And if you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. See you next episode. Goodbye.